Mandatory health insurance doesn't really meet the goal that the advocates for mandatory health insurance have. In fact, we all share the same goal. No one wants a family to lose their house because somebody in the family gets sick and they didn't have health insurance. But we can fix this problem without requiring that everyone in the United States buy a product that many people don't need. So let me illustrate why. We hear every day that 47 million people are uninsured. Let's break that down. 14 million of those people actually already have health insurance. They haven't enrolled in the program, they haven't signed up yet, but they're eligible for Medicaid or SCHIPS or one of the other government-run programs. In fact, 6 million of the 9 million children who are considered uninsured already are eligible for government programs. So on the other end of the 47 million uninsured, over 10 million earn more than live in households with incomes of over $75,000 a year. So they've chosen not to buy health insurance, but they could afford to buy some sort of health insurance. That leaves about 23 million people who need help affording health insurance. And there are ways to make health insurance more affordable for them without chucking the best healthcare system in the world and moving to a government mandate. Well, right now, the United States spends about $2.1 trillion on healthcare. Frankly, I think we're getting our money's worth in many ways. We have the highest recovery rates after a major illness, for example. So if you have cancer in your family or heart disease, better to be in the United States than anywhere else. But right now, we spend $2.1 trillion. Now, the same candidates who are saying we're going to increase access for everybody are saying we're going to lower costs. It doesn't make any sense. Think about it. You're going to guarantee everybody more access to health care, and you're going to reduce that $2.1 trillion number at the same time. You know that can't be possible. There is no tooth fairy.